May I request Mr. Mukund Kaushal to start his session on the problem we face at the work spot, ethics at the work spot. Many people tell you to do things which you don't want to, but you yet have to sometimes. When you have to say no, it requires a lot of courage. And there are many stories that Mr. Kaushal will tell you about how to say no and when to say no. Mr. Kaushal.
मुझे ऐसे परिस्थितियों में बोलने को कहा गया है कि आप सबको भूख भी लग रही है, लंच टाइम भी हो गया है, अनिल स्वरूप बता ही चुके हैं इंतजार करना मुश्किल हो रहा है, तो आप सोच सकते हैं खाने के बाद इमीडिएटली बोलना भी बड़ा मुश्किल होता है, लोगों को नींद आती है, और खाने के पहले इतनी भूख लगने का टाइम हो गया तो पता नहीं, शायद ऑर्गेनाइजर्स आर नॉट इन माई फेवर, सो दे हैव सेलेक्टेड मी फॉर दिस। अच्छा, इसके बाद एक वार्निंग भी दी है कि अगर मिनिस्टर आ गए तो आप रुक जाइएगा। तो खैर, मुझे कोई, हम तो सरकारी आदमी, इतने साल नौकरी कर ले आप सरकार की तो एक खराबी हो जाती है, जो आपको आदेश मिलता है आप उसको करने लग जाते हैं। 40 साल तक पुलिस की नौकरी करी तो फिर वो आदत ही बन जाती है कि भाई जो बताया जाए वही करिए आप। एनीवे, दूसरी दिक्कत ये है कि इतने पावरफुल स्पीकर बोल चुके हैं, प्रभात कुमार साहब बोल चुके हैं, हम लोग सब बैचमेट्स हैं, मैं, प्रभात, मिस्टर शांति नारायण, और ये सेंटर में हम सब एक साथ काम करते हैं, लेकिन प्रभात कुमार के बाद बोलना ज़रा मुश्किल है, और फिर अनिल स्वरूप बोले, काफ़ी ज़ोर शोर से बोले, तो थोड़ा सा मुश्किल होगा बोलना मेरे लिए, और हर वक्त ये डर रहेगा कि कहीं मिनिस्टर ना आ जाए। मेरा मानना ये है कि प्रभात जी ने बताया कि एथिक्स क्या है, उसके बारे में बताया, उसकी रेलिवेंस और इम्पोर्टेंस बताई फॉर दी इन द मैटर्स रिलेटिंग टू गवर्नेंस, और अनिल स्वरूप साहब ने बताया नेक्सस ऑफ गुड, विच इज अ वेरी गुड कॉन्सेप्ट, बहुत ही अच्छी चीज बताई उन्होंने। मुझे थोड़ा सा डिफरेंट बोलना, मुझे कहा गया कि मैं रिस्पॉन्स एट द वर्क प्लेस, प्रैक्टिकल सिचुएशन में कैसे रिस्पॉन्ड, क्या करना चाहिए, व्हाट इज एथिकल रिस्पॉन्स, what should be ethical response at the workplace in different situations. So it will be more of stories, sharing of experience, and usme mujhe thoda sa dhyan rakhna hai kyunki main jo bhi experience bataunga apna bataunga, aur Anil Swarup ne warning kari hai ki apni baat nahi karni chahiye, to koshish karunga usme jo cheez, jo principle underlying hai wo bahut zyada important hai, jo uske piche siddhant hai ki kyon kara gaya wo zyada important hai, ye nahi important hai ki kisne kiya, वो ज्यादा इम्पोर्टेंट है। मैं इससे पहले कि मैं अपना सब्जेक्ट शुरू करूं, मैं चाहूंगा बोलना, एक ऑब्जर्वेशन करना अबाउट दी एथिक्स। आई पर्सनली फील एथिक्स इज नॉट ए नेचुरल सेंटिमेंट, इट हैज टू बी कल्टिवेटेड। देयर इज अनदर व्यू दैट इट्स पार्ट ऑफ ह्यूमन नेचर, इट गेट डिस्टॉर्टेड, पीपुल गेट एस्ट्रेज इन कोर्स ऑफ टाइम बिकॉज ऑफ प्रेशर्स, एज समबडी मेंशनड इट ऑल्सो, that because of circumstances and pressures we deviate from the path, but in either case the solution lies that it has to be cultivated. Now what are the factors which help in cultivating this sentiment, which contribute in cultivating this sentiment? According to me, the one important factor, these are not the very exhaustive, this is only, I mean, what I think will contribute. One is the background, your background, that is the education, your education, your values imbibed by you, your background in which environment in which you have grown, that contributes in making the mental makeup of a person and his attitude. The other, but it's not necessary. I have seen people who have no such advantage and have been very ethical throughout their life. Similarly, the other factor which is important is your commitment to work and pride about the job you are doing or pride in the organization you are serving. I mean, you are serving a very big organization which is serving the entire nation. So you can be proud of that fact, and this will help you in cultivating this sentiment. And one more factor is important, and that is your immediate seniors and colleagues, especially when you start the service. They also help you in forming your views on the how much ethical you could be and how you have to be ethical and how advantageous it is. This will help in doing that. But what we need today, I mean, generally, not only in railways, elsewhere is also, what we need is change in attitude of the workforce. That is the real problem. Now, for that, emphasis should be given on integrity. Satyanishtha is the mission your chairman has given you. And secondly, the public service, which Mr. Prabhat Kumar mentioned. Both these aspects are very important. And for this, the leadership of a force, leadership of an organization at different level is very important. They play a very important role in this. No, this is just an observation I wanted to make about ethics in general. My subject is a response at the workplace, ethical response at the workplace. So what could be the possible challenges? There could be many challenges, ethical challenges at the workplace, but I have broadly put them in three categories. One is, when you are handling, as a public servant, you are handling a situation, dealing with a situation which requires your decision. And you feel and you realize that what you think is ethically correct is not in consonance with what your immediate senior authority or authorities expect you to do, then you are facing an ethical dilemma. Now, in this case, I have used the word that they expect you to do. They have not given you a written order. If there is a written order, then there will be no problem. You face ethical dilemma because you have to take a decision, deal with the situation. And in that situation, your seniors have given you an oral order, which according to you is not ethically correct. The second could be a situation where there are two options. Both are by and large correct. One is totally correct, but causes very large damage. The other, if you opt for the other, that will save a lot of damage, but it will need some little ethical deviation. That could be second type of situation, second category of dilemmas. The third is where the orders have been passed by senior authority. You find its implementation, there are difficulties, ethical issues come, it is causing trouble, inconvenience to a lot of people. So these could be the situations. Now, I'm making these few starting points so that when I narrate incidents after this incident explaining all these points, you can understand. I have used the expression ethically correct. Now, there are a lot of discussion on what is correct and what is not correct. So I'm not going into that because I also believe that you have to decide yourself what is correct and what in a particular situation. So, but if you raise, four questions while facing a situation, you will find that you may probably get the correct answer. Not necessarily that you will get a correct answer, but probably you will get a correct answer. That is it legal? Does it violate any situation, whatever decision you are going to take? Then is it just? If there are two or three parties, have you taken into consideration everybody's stake, all stakeholders have been taken into consideration? And the third, whether it is in public interest or not. That's the third test. But the fourth, according to me, is very important, that how do you see yourself after you have taken this decision? Whether you will like it to be known to your family, whether you will like it to be known to, if it becomes public by going to press. So all those situations, but this is the most important. How do you see see yourself after you have taken a decision. This is very important. Because normally you cannot hide it to yourself. And every time you will see, it was said, I think, when you see mirror, you can see, you will see the real self. If you have done wrong, you will feel the pain throughout. Now, after this, I thought I'll mention about the situations, which is the coming directly to the subject. Situations where such challenges are faced. Now, you face these situations normally when in two types of situations. One, vis-a-vis others, you and vis-a-vis others. That is, your seniors or your juniors. And you can also face the situation yourself, and you have to take your own decision. In all cases, you have to take decision, but there are other people who are involved. So I'm talking about when it involves seniors. So first I'll take you vis-a-vis your seniors. Now, if your seniors give you an order, tells you something, and tells you oral, gives you an oral order that you do such and such thing, which you feel is not ethically correct, question is what you do at that time. Whatever I am going to narrate is my practical experience over the years, over about 39 years, I have served the government. And in all these things are backed by one or other incident. Now, in the situation where he tells you something which you feel is not ethically correct, the first attempt should be that you try to persuade him, try to very politely explain him that your difficulty is in implementing it, that it is difficult to implement its pros and cons. You try to explain. Normally it works. I have seen it. I got such oral instructions, and I made an effort to persuade. In most of the cases, I succeeded. Sometimes you don't succeed, and then you pay the cost. The cost in government servant means you are transferred. Normally, unless somebody is very vicious and carries it further, it is normally that you are removed from the post. I was fighting for pay scale, better. I was DG at CRPF, and I was fighting for the better pay scales of CRPF, and all, including all paramilitary forces. And the matter was discussed in front of Prime Home Minister and then Prime Minister, and somehow the impression got, since I was speaking very intensely for arguing for this upgradation of scales. I was not asking for changing in the same scale, extra increment in the same scale. I was asking for better pay scale, different pay scale. So government, after a lot of persuasion, then they decided that it should be not that I was any trade union leader, I was only DG CRPF, but it was, the Prime Minister had told Home Minister that you would discuss it if you can satisfy, try to sort it out with him. So it was, this matter was discussed with me, and after a lot of persuasion, I could convince him, and better pay scales were given, not only to CRPF, but to about 6.5 lakhs. And since I was earlier DG RPF also, I was in RPF for 10 years. So I had included, I got this RPF included in this also. So the benefit of rupees, I think about 550 rupees to about 6.5 lakhs was given. And one rank was abolished, which accelerated the promotion. After a month or so, I could feel that I was feeling little uncomfortable because there was a lot of propaganda going against me. As you know, when you get important, then your friends start working against you. So they had a very powerful lobby, and they could see that I'm removed from the post of DGCRPF and thrown to a very sent to a very unimportant, insignificant post in the Home Ministry. Later on, after some time, the minister realized that wrong has been done to me. He rectified it, created a post of Secretary Kashmir, and posted me there. But I paid the cost, but cost was only this transfer. And CRPF officers wanted to go and protest. I said, no, you will only prove the allegation. The allegation was that I am trying to assume leadership of the police, while I was only pleading, because there I was sensing some sort of discontent in the force. So I had warned the government also that there is a discontent and something like what happened in 1979, and there was a sort of revolt in different forces. So I had warned the government. So this was all misconstrued, but later on they realized and this was not done. Anyway, what I'm saying is that if you stick to the correct thing, vis-a-vis seniors, then it helps you. I was posted as IG Goa. I had only 12 years of service, but that post was of IG's rank and power, but my seniority was that of a senior SP, and I was posted there. An opportunity came, there were some vacancies in the rank of DYSPs. So I was I asked the government that this is one opportunity, I should promote the local officers, and a DPC was formed, and I recommended three senior most. The DPC consisted of me as chairman, one superintendent police, and one joint secretary from the administration. So we recommended the name of three senior most people, and they were not only senior, they deserved, their record was outstanding, so that they should be promoted. Normally this promotion should have taken place, in the order should have come in next 15 days or 20 days, but orders didn't turn up. Then I checked up with the chief secretary why it is pending. So chief secretary told me that chief minister is interested in promoting the fourth person whom I had not recommended. So I said all the three seniors are outstanding and they are senior and the record is good, so I have no right to ignore them and supersede them. And this fourth, if you want the fourth person to be promoted, give me the fourth vacancy. Now this fourth vacancy was not given, but in the process, since I did not yield to that, I was convinced that the DPC is not, DPC proceedings have been lost. And another DPC was formed, and I was second time asked to make another DPC.
No, it is up to you.
Anyway, I'm sorry, I'm told that lunch is ready. Anyway.
This is just a break and not closure of the session. There has been situations that have been changing around, and we now request you to join for lunch. The lunch break is for 45 minutes. After that, Mr. Mukund Kaushal will continue with this session. Thank you.